Hello, my name is Cream, and welcome back to Europa Universalis IV as Russia. Okay, so let's continue with our campaign. Okay, speed 4. And we are still trying to catch. We need institutions. We really need that. What's that? Global trade. We still need 2,500 ducats. Only 9 diplo points. Need to do something about it. Why we have only 9 diplo points? Because our ruler is quite not good. Nine corruption. I guess we could debase our currency several times. And we could take military tech 18. Okay, navies. Why are you not doing anything? Cancel mission. You will protect raid in Novgorod. Finally. You are sailing. Okay, from Novgorod we are gaining almost 40 ducats. Oh, this army doesn't have any leaders, so you need leader. Okay, we have to worry about Kazani separatists. Okay, Kazani separatists, if you will fire, or when you will fire in Pokrovsk or Tamishin. Pokrovsk. Here. And commission is here. 12 and sound open, so there's bigger chance that you will fire in commission. We have 4 leaders. Where is the fourth guy? Oh, here. You know what? You move to commission. You can move to Pokrovsk. Let's see where those Kazan separatists will fire if they're gonna fire. Rackets. We are gaining 18 rackets. I like that. So once again, we can build Basilica. You know, let's build Basilica in St. Petersburg and one in Cizran. Let's see, we will get our money back. Hey Mark, you like me? Plus 199 return provinces and France. Let's insult you, or we cannot. I don't think we need to build spy network in Sweden, so let's stop that. And let's insult France. You are at war with Oldenburg, Lorraine, Lüneburg, Brandenburg, Frankfurt. Okay, Big Blue Blob is quite strong in this campaign. Okay, let's send insults to France. So our power projection will go up. Oh, you are third rank, great power, huh? Awesome. Naval officers retiring, unfortunate. Secret and alliances just got him from important affairs. Corruption's growing, provincial unrest. Finnish separatists may happen. Hungarian and Swedish. You know what? I think we could support Opryshnina. They are kept at 150. So yeah, let's use Opryshnina. Now everyone's rebellion went down. Gain prestige or gain base tax in Tausik. Yeah, let's gain that one base tax. Now we have 4 development provinces there. Before Protect their independence. So what's our patriarchal authority? 195? Oh, we can gain money. Missionary strength would be 2%. Local unrest would go down. Local manpower modifier would go up. You know what? Let's get money. And provinces are our cores. Great. You can lose 25 people power. And Georgia will be happy. Not yet. A couple of our most talented diplomats will be sent to aid them. Offensive idea. Recruitment time minus 10%. Okay, we need two more ideas and we will get more of armies plus 5%. Fire damage received minus 10%, which will be nice. And our Russian finisher is yearly legitimacy plus 1. For now, I think we need to take military tech 17 and we don't need to take diplotech 18. But you know what? Let's debase our currency. How much money do we need? 2,300. Okay, what's happening? How long until... Okay, this global trade is spreading quite slowly. Yeah, let's debase our currency. Now, we should have enough money. Yep, we have enough money, great. So let's embrace global trade. We have free merchant, nice. So, or not yet. I guess we will get him in December. We don't have money, we will have money. Let's take military tech 18. We're gonna have enough diplo points for diplotech 18 in December 47, that means in 3 years. And we can get better artillery, so let's take leather cannons. And we have free merchant. Okay, so where are we gonna send you? Okay, trade from Persia is going to Aleppo. Oh, I guess Samarkand. It would be nice if you could get some trade from Samarkand to Astrakhan. Well, yeah, let's do that. Let's train power from Samarkand to Astrakhan. Well, hopefully we will get something out of that trade. Let's see how successful that's gonna be. We've managed to convert heretics of Goriev. Okay, let's convert heathens of Ustiurt. Okay, we are pushing 4.57 ducats. Okay, we need to take land from Persia and Delhi. And Kokand, you are allied with Mongolia. Oh, you are allied with Mongolia. You would attack Kokand. If you declare war on Kokand, you could actually take land from Mongolia. Problem is, we need to get border with Kokand, and for that we need to fight Persia. Wait, you pay, you're at war with Mamluks. Okay, let's build spine for against Persia. Ottomans, what are we gonna do with 100 spy network? Support rebels? No. We can sabotage recruitment or slander merchants. Yeah, let's sabotage recruitment. Let's build spy network in Persia. And we don't need to be building spy network in Ottomans. France. Seems like you are losing your war. Let's build spy network in France. Oh, and I wanted. Now I want what I wanted. You return from France. Let's send you to Krasnodarsk. Land you. Mutugilan. I think it's time to delete. I think it's time to destroy Tabarastan. Okay, here we have level 5-4. So we need siege guy in this army. And we need fighter guy in this army. And in few days we will give Mazandaran and Golestan to Georgia. Let's make Georgia a little bit stronger. And hopefully after that we will be a little closer to declaring war on Persia. Oh, you moved on great province. Now we don't have to fight you in mountains, but we can fight you in desert. Yeah, let's lower speed to 3 and let's declare war on Tabarastan. And it doesn't matter, but we can take Golestan. You move to Golestan, you move to Mazandaran. September 4. Oh, we are actually losing. Oh, I didn't expect that. Oh, they have better morale. How? Oh, because they are pious. Army tradition. Okay, I must say, I didn't expect this. Yeah, army is quite terrible. We need maneuver guy or someone who can be useful for us. Okay, summon the second. You move to a steward. So where are you retreating? Oh, you are retreating to Perm? Ottomans declare war on Persia. Oh, Persia. You are being attacked by Ottomans. Okay, let's send this army to this area too. I guess we can attack Persia after we will deal with Tabarastan. If we're gonna deal with Tabarastan. Okay, let's do artillery barrage so we can finish this war a little bit faster. Armies are slowly moving. Rebel pricing 80%. Oh, Denmark, what's happening with you? You have some rebels, Catholic zealots. Denmark, you are Protestant. Okay, like most of Europe. Finally. Oh! So, I kind of think we won't actually win Battle in Mazandaran unless we will send reinforcements there. Our truce with Dutch West Indies has ended. Blamed Star, we're gonna lose one stability. Damn it. Okay, I guess we can increase our stability again. Or boost our stability. Okay, when you will arrive? February 28th. Yes, if you're gonna be lucky. Damn it. You could have lasted for a few more days. Okay, so let's see. So disappearing. We must regain control of the salt market. With corruption ever on the rise in Russia. An increasing amount of salt has been disappearing from our legitimate trade networks on the black market. Okay, guys, get to Urgent. You are retreating as Astrakhan. Okay, you go to Golestan, then you can return to Mazandaran. You can go to Kiva, Persia. Where do you have your forts? In Bukhara, Herat, and Isfahan. Ooh, Ottomans, are you actually losing war against Persia? Well, at least for now, Persia gained one province. Who knows what's gonna happen in future. Okay, you move to Mazandaran. This army has three siege guys, so that's gonna be more important. Let's do our third barrage, so we can finish our war against Tabrazdan as fast as possible. Okay, we can go with, we can use speed 4. Also, Amchad Gauls. Let's break a claim on Kamchatka. Great. Now we have to worry about Swedish separatists. Okay, that's gonna be okay. Denmark, Frederick the First, fourth of Denmark has died. A royal marriage with Denmark has ended. Oh, France, you are losing. I like that. Okay, Denmark, let's do royal marriage. What mission do you have? Danish trade? The unsupported cities have long been the center of the Danish trade. However, this situation is no longer suitable. Denmark must control the major ports along the Baltic coast by any means necessary. I think that's gonna happen. Also, what mission do we have? Yeah, colonize Kelang. Okay, what's happening with our colony in Taoisk? 700 men? Okay, and we need advisor. Sabbaticals modifier or national unrest? Let's take national unrest guy. Austria declared war on Venice. Okay, you move to Krasnovodsk. And let's be ready to finish our war against Tabrastan. Oh, we need more artillery. Okay, let's send you to Mazandaran. Oh, siege of Mazandaran is over. Great. So, Tabrastan, give me money. Also, Mazandaran and Tabrastan or Golestan will go to Georgia. And let's finish this war. And what do we want from Persia? Karakum, wide open, 3-11. Okay, let's take Huriai. Pretty claim. Huriai, let's take it. And let's wait. Also, you need better leader, someone with free siege. You move to Stuart. You go move to Krasnovodsk. You move to Gurkani. And our diplomat has returned. Armies are ready. So yeah, let's attack Persia. Ethiopia won't join, that's great. Now you move to Bukhara. Okay, you move to Konjikala, Karum, and Kopetdak. Oh no, you can move. No, siege one guy, where are you hiding? Here? No, here. Yep, you move to Isfahan. No, it's being sieged. That's okay, move to Split. So you can move to Semnan. It's okay. And Persian army, where are you hiding? Or how many crews do you have? Not that many. Unless your army is good or average. I think one of our armies can could defeat you. Okay, you go to Bornyard, Kanikala. And let's convert heretics of Mangisla. Religious unity 90%. Queen of the people. We can lose money, gain, lose 15 army power, national unrest minus 2. Okay. We will have minus 7.46% unrest. Or we can gain legitimacy. Let's be honest, I don't like losing money and admin power. We have more important matters to deal with. Okay, Nash is sieging Isfahan. Russia occupies Konjikala. Okay, let's split this army in half and let's siege Kariyui and Mer. Bukhara is in our hands, awesome. Let's split you in half. And let's split you in half. Oh, you can move to Tehran. No problem, let's take different provinces. Once again. Okay, you move to Birgyan. And after that, we should loot some Persian land, like Tehran. As for that, we need to take... Someone will have to take Isfahan. The Dolgorukovsk. Prominent Dolgorukov family has offered to fund expansion into Tyusk and surrounding area, committing to the construction of forts there for the benefit of Tsardom. Excellent idea. You're gonna gain money. I'm okay with that. Yeah, excellent idea. Alcon in Tyusk is self-sustaining, awesome. The fort there, which is nice. Okay, now let's colonize Kelang. Our colonists will sail there for 700 days. And we can take Diplo Technology 18. So yeah, let's do that. Oh, you are moving to Markazi. You know, siege guy. Oh, move to Yazd. I think we could help our... We can help this army in Isfahan. I really want to loot Tehran. Recruitment time plus 40%. I don't plan on building any troops, so I'm gonna be okay with that. Birjan is in under occupation. Great. So which province? We can loot. For now, you can stay in those four provinces. Problem there. Oh, and we have a loan. Yep. So let's repay it. Now we don't have any loan. Nice. Libertas Ecclesiae. The clergy has long been one of the foremost pillars of the Russian realm, providing not only spiritual guidance but also administrators, judges, and diplomats for the benefit of our Tsar. In return for those great services, no ecclesiarch manor, monastery, or other estate pay any taxes. Make it clear that they need to contribute, or we will find money elsewhere. Let's get prestige. I definitely do not want to lose patriarch authority. So yeah, let's get prestige and better relations with clergy. Clergy. Burgers. Let's grant you monopoly charters. Let's grant you new world charter. Draft ships for the war. can grant you admiralship. Oh, your influence would be 80%. That's too much. You could recruit minister, you would gain more influence, and we could demand 150 admin little points. You know what? Yeah, let's recruit minister, and now we can demand diplomatic support. Clergy. Let's seek support of clergy. Inquisitor. Oh, skill 3 Inquisitor. You know what? Yeah, let's recruit Inquisitor. And now we can demand administrator. Oh, we need 10 more influence. Gain 15 influence. I don't think we can get 10. 15 is too much. Okay, it's okay. So let's demand only 100 admin power. And boyars, can we get 10? Oh yeah, we can get 10 influence. We can get 10 influence. Let's go that. And now I want demand 115 military power. Great. And we have that Inquisitor. Six ducats? Okay, let's hire him. Our conversions will be a little bit faster. So what idea can we take? Offensive idea? Recruitment time minus 10%? Yeah, we want this broaden the circum of the cadet corps. So we can finish. I don't want this and our finisher. So yeah, I guess. Oh no, let's take Gustavian infantry. Pavel First Turekovich is now new ruler. Okay, 3-3-4. I like him. Oh, you guys, move to Isfahan. Denmark, you want trail marriage? I'm gonna accept that. We have new wife. Anne Porsche. He's from Denmark. Okay, no loot in Merv anymore. Okay, you can move to Hargai. No loot in Bukhara. Okay, you move to Kumis. You can go move to Birchan. Oh, try to get to Tehran. I don't think you'll get there. But that's okay. Even if we won't take it. Let's take that route from Tehran. Rebel uprising, Swedish separatists, no problem. Russia, I don't care about your peace. Oh, number of states, we can get more states, nice. And Gustavian infantry will be available in April? No, in March. Oh, now in February. Great, let's take it. Money! Gain 1 basics in Veshansakaya. Great. I don't care about your piece of Persia. And we can take our better infantry. So let's choose Saxon infantry. Also, how much money do we need for manufacturers? 523 ducats. Okay, so we don't need to this province anymore. You can go to Sabzayaf. You guys try to get to Ardakan. And you definitely go to Kerman. Okay, my plan is definitely not to finish this war before Ottomans. I don't want Ottomans to be that strong. So this war will be finished either when Ottomans will finish their war with Persia or when we will get call for peace. And it's time to finish this episode, but before we go, let's take our new military advisor. Discipline plus 5%, yeah? Welcome, Gavril Sheremete. And if you enjoyed this episode, please continue watching and have a nice rest of your day. Goodbye.